Hi everyone. Today we're going to be talking about 19th century pianos, in particular those made by the company named Erard. This company was founded by Sébastien Erard, who was a Frenchman innovator who brought many improvements to the modern harp and piano. The most notable one on the piano is the double escapement mechanism. This piano is from about 1840, and this piano is from about 1895. This piano lived in the same estate for about 115 years in Brussels and was a part of a salon. It could have easily been played by composers like Fauré, Ravel, and many notable pianists of the time. This piano, on the other hand, could have been played by Mendelssohn, by Chopin, and by Clara Schumann, who was a great fan of Erard pianos and always requested to play on an Erard when possible when she was touring. As you can see, these pianos have all strings parallel to one another. That's parallel stringing. In contrast to modern pianos, which have bass strings at a diagonal crossing over the strings that would be in the tenor register. What parallel stringing does is it allows for more clarity between the registers, so we have more timbral distinction between bass, tenor, alto, and soprano. This is in contrast to modern pianos, which are cross-strung and have the bass strings going over the tenor strings at a diagonal angle. Cross-stringing allows for more vibration, resonance, and bigger projection in today's concert halls. In a way, parallel stringing allows the piano to resonate more like a string instrument. If you think of the violin strings and how they're across the instrument, it's very similar to think of that when it comes to parallel stringing across the soundboard. And in fact, the soundboards of the Erard pianos are quarter sawn, which is very similar to how the plates of the violins are cut as well. Also, if you look at the dampers, in these pianos, they come from under the strings. So when you depress the pedal, the dampers actually go down. And then when you let go of the pedal, they come up. So when we use the pedal, what essentially happens is the dampers release the strings and the strings resonate more. And in modern pianos, we have dampers that come from above. Another distinct feature in the Erard pianos is the way these hammers are put together. You can see very many layers in these hammers, and those are comprised of leather, hard felt, medium felt, and soft felt. And what this allows a player to do is change the color by accessing different points in the hammer depending on the strength of the touch. So the touch may be activating just the soft felt, or it might be much more powerful and might activate all the layers of the hammer. By now you can tell that pianos from this time were not particularly standardized, especially between makers, time periods, and even countries. What you see here is called fausse table, and it refers to a fake tabletop. This is used just to cover up the strings for aesthetic reasons, and it also dampens the sound a little bit. And it was used in very noble pianos that were used in concerts and concert salons. In conclusion, these differences in the action of these pianos, whether it's the parallel stringing or the registral distinctions across the keyboard, or the dampers that come from underneath the strings, we can really delve into the nuanced markings of pedaling and articulation and dynamics from the composers of the 19th century. We can really get into the sound world of why the composers wrote what they did and try to bring that from these instruments to the modern pianos and the contemporary concert hall.